Hey there, I'm Yannick and this is Isoprod. This week I spent every second and minute that I had for game development to implement new weapons, and so let's not waste time and let me show you what I've done. A sword is an awesome weapon. Just take a piece of metal, sharpen it, and voila, you got your sword. Use it to cut and hit your way through all the enemies, but most importantly, as John once said to Aria, stick them with a pointy end. But if you really like sticking, I may have something better for you. Stab them with your spear. Well, this is actually even easier than to hit them with your sword, and you probably won't have any problems to stab your way through every arena. Just remember, you always also move a little bit forward, so keep care of this. But if you think that stabbing and hitting your way through all your enemies is too simplistic, I may have something for you that is a little bit more beautiful and elegant. If you want to feel like a samurai, use the katana. You probably will already know how to use the sword if you played my last game, Dash Arena. If you haven't played that game, shame on you. No, really, shame on you. You should play it now. But if you still don't want to play it, it's okay. Then you have to wait for this game to come out to see how you can dash through your enemies with this beautiful sword. This game will play in the European medieval time. I know the katana is an Eastern weapon and it's not actually a medieval weapon, so it's not perfectly fitting. To compensate for this, the next weapon I show you is a perfect example for the medieval age. The lightsaber was the most important weapon of the Middle Age. Just imagine what would have happened if King Arthur hadn't his lightsaber ready when he fought Richard the Lionheart at the foot of the Mountain of Doom to destroy the One Ring. Probably Voldemort would have taken over all the world. So to honor this event, I of course implemented this weapon in my game. You can use your lightsaber to roast your opponents, or in case of an emergency, when you're really, really hungry, you can roast your bread. But if this weapon isn't manly enough for you, I have something else. The Great Axe is a weapon only for the manliest mans. It's large, it's heavy, and it's looking really dangerous. Just look how beautiful this axe cut through all your opponents. Oh, awesome. But for those who aren't manly enough to fight their enemies in melee combats, I also have some ranged weapons. The next one is a weapon you can't miss in a medieval game, so of course I implemented it. The 9mm pistol is not only good for shooting your enemies and drive-bys in your neighborhood, it strongly increases your gangster attitude and your street credibility. You just have to hold it the right way. But if you really want to use it, you should be better at aiming with this, or you should instead use the next weapon of the list. Using an automatic gun definitely helps with aiming. Rapidly shooting up to 20 bullets at your enemies to perforate them feels kinda good. No wonder this was the most used weapon in the Third Crusade, 1189. But shooting bullets at your enemies is so 12th century. That's why you should prefer the next and last weapon on the list. Why should you use normal bullets when you can shoot yourself at your enemies? I personally have no answer to this question, so I would always prefer the player shooting gun. Just put yourself in the gun, aim at a point and shoot yourself. As easy and fun as it can ever get. So these are the new weapons that I implemented. I would love to know if you like them or don't like them, so write it down in the comments, and also tell me if you have other great ideas for new weapons. Write them down and I will see if I can implement them. And if you're interested in how this game will work out in the end and what new kind of ideas and weapons and enemies and what else I will implement, just consider subscribing and click right there. And if you missed the last week's videos, just go to the playlist for this game. Great. I hope we will see you again. So, bye bye.